Algeiri, how are you feeling tonight? We're here in Vegas.
Feeling good. I'm feeling like it's a Canelo fight week, man.
Okay, Canelo takes care of business. That's what most people say. What does he do next? Does he fight the winner of Bivol Bitterbaev?
I don't think so.
Why not?
I don't know. First of all, I mean, that's going to be a while away between if that fight even happens next, you know, when it's supposed to.
October
also,
12th.
Also, who's to say we don't have a rematch? Who's to say we don't have a rubber match? Who's to say both men come out unharmed? I think, you know, May is Canelo's going to be Canelo's next date. So I don't think it's going to be those guys. I wouldn't be surprised if it was Crawford, even though that Canelo has kind of feigned in his interest of that. I know Crawford's looking for that fight, but I could see Mbili entering the fray, especially if they're his last win. So there's some options out there, but I don't know. I don't see the Bivol rematch happening next.
You mentioned Crawford. I think he's way too small. As talented as he is, there's weight class for a reason. 54, he looked okay.
Right.
We didn't see. How does he do a 68 against a powerhouse like Canelo?
If there's anybody who can overcome the size, it would be a guy like Crawford. He has a very deep bag of skills. He's a dog, man. He's super competitive. But I tend to agree with you. There's weight classes for a reason. He's not a young man either. He's older than Canelo, right?
Yeah.
37, 38 by the time that fight comes off. Age is real. Size is real. It's not the fight that I want, but listen, if it gets Crawford paid the money that he deserves, I get it.
Okay, what about Teofimo and Crawford? I just talked to Tio. He told me, Ellie, I stopped Crawford in 9.
Wow, that's a bold statement. I don't see that one happening either. I don't think, and based on where Crawford's looking, you know, he's looking for big, big money fights. I don't know if that generates the interest or the capital to get a guy like Crawford to take that fight. Crawford's looking for the biggest money possible, thus the Canelo fight.
You mentioned Bivol Bitterbaev. Who wins that one, Chris?
I've been flip-flopping on this one. I was always a Bivol guy based on his boxing skills, but then Bitterbaev has looked so good recently. But the inactivity, the age, I'm back on the Bivol train.
I agree with you, the Bivol. Then Bivol against Benavidez. Who do you like? They sparred in the past.
I love that fight. I love Benavidez with all these guys. I think he's a monster. He really is. And I think he's getting better. His potential is to be the star of the sport, honestly, in my eyes. Tough fight based on the experience and just the style. Bivol is a problem for every single person in the world because of that style. Hard to say who I would pick at this point. I gotta see Benavidez at 75 more.
Okay, it looks like he might fight Jesse Hart, but if Canelo does fight Bivol, if it happens, who do you like?
Canelo, Bivol, I got Bivol again.
You got Bivol. Okay, now, right now there's a lot of talk who's the pound for pound king. For me, it's Tank. Who do you have as the number one guy in the sport?
Pound for pound? Crawford, Usyk. Those are my top three. I think Inoue is knocking on the door, but I still got him probably at number three. It's hard to go against Usyk right now, but I mean, we're splitting hairs in terms of Usyk and Crawford in my eyes.
And what do you want to see Tank do next? He has endless options from, who's that, Sugar Shane O'Malley called him out, and I've seen every boxer.
I think he's going to fight Ryo. I think he moves up to 40. Ryo has a belt now. He's got an opportunity to jump up and fight for a title right away.
But Robert told me that's not going to happen this year, so he needs to fight someone else this year.
All right, yeah, so listen, I like Tank with everybody. I really enjoy watching Tank. I always have. He's got a fantastic style. You know, he's a crowd pleaser. He's a ticking time bomb, man. He'll fall back in rounds. He doesn't care. He stays cool, stays calm. Very underrated boxing IQ as well. I don't know what's next for him, honestly. I think he has a date now. They announced the doubleheader with him and Benavidez. I'm curious to see who's gonna get the shot.
You spent some time in Oxnard way back when, you and Maidana with the Argentina crew.
Uh-huh.
What do you remember? What makes Robert Garcia such a great trainer? Because so far this year, he's leading the pack with all the wins. With Virgil, with Bam, with...
Robert's on his way to fight trainer of the year, for sure. One, it's just the system. You've been there, Ellie. You know how it is. That system that he has there. As iron sharpens iron, there's so many good guys, and there's such good sparring. And then just Robert, man. Robert in the corner. He's a fighter. He's been there. He's a world champion. He's been there. He knows what it's like to make snap decisions. He stays very, very calm. He's got an eye for the sport, of course. Robert's the man right now. I really love what he's doing, and I cherish my time there. I did four camps there, like you said. Speaking of which, Trevor McCombie was there at that time.
Shout out to Trevor. Everyone in Hollywood, the same dude, very chill. Not easy fight planned, but it's boxing.
Mm-hmm.
I hope he comes out good, and we'll see what happens. So last thing, then this interview. If you could come back and fight one person, who would it be?
Oh, man, I haven't thought about fighting in such a long time.
You're still in shape. You could fight. If you wanted to fight, you could fight.
I can still make 40, too.
And Ryan Garcia?
That would be a fight, man. That would be.
Ryan, I got another opponent for you. What happened? What's your prediction?
No, I'm not fighting anymore. That's not happening. I don't even know who's around anymore, honestly, that I always thought about fighting, but I'm going to come back to him.
Okay, last one to end this interview. Ryan against Teofimo, who do you like?
Ryan's too big, man. I don't see him fighting at 40 anymore. I don't think he's going to be able to get down there. He might not even fight at 47, you know, because we still got a bunch of months before he comes back. Ryan's a big, big dude, man. He's getting bigger.
Team Danny Garcia have arrived. Everyone's here. Ricky Lopez in the house. How's it going? So, Chris, tell people where to follow you.
Yeah, just my Instagram, man. Find me on Chris Algeiri.
Everywhere. And very opinionated. Whether you love him or you hate him, just listen.
That's right.
You let people comment. You don't block people, right?
No.
Okay. Stay tuned. Chris Algeiri, the one and only. Ellie said back reporting. Thanks, Chris. What's the prediction for tonight? Danny and Lara, what do we got? What's up, Ricky?
And the new?
what round?
We're about to part.
just
10 or 11.
Just Danny winning, that's it? Just a win.
Seven?
Let me get those. What about Canelo Lara? Who you got?
Canelo.
I mean, Canelo Berlanga.
Canelo.
Isn't this the Puerto Rican crew?
Cakewalk.
Huh?
Cakewalk.
How many rounds do you think?
Probably four.
All right, let's see what happens. What's up, Ricky? You got big, huh?
Yeah, nah, I'm
When we're here at the fights, people waiting to go in. It's a packed house, as you can see. It's getting busy. Fans are chanting Canelo. You hear them yelling Canelo. There's also another event in town with the UFC. Here we hear the horns. The Canelo fans came out, they're excited.
I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
Both fighters went to the hospital. So, you can't. I saw a lot of media outlets just wrote Virgil went to the hospital. Both fighters had to be checked out. It was a tough fight. And Virgil's good. Boychuk's good. They both got released. And they're both going to move on with their career. There's a lot of talk, like I said, Virgil against Crawford. And Boychuk, well, he could fight Madrimov. He could fight a lot of other guys at 154. He's a good fighter, an entertaining fighter. And I'm sure if he sticks with it, he'll do great. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.